Want to discover many design options without duplicating a single Figma frame? Let's break it down. In this video, I will show how to do exactly that using Lovable, an AI tool that takes your Figma wireframes and instantly helps you to explore visual styles, color palettes, and more. Let's get started. Today I want to talk with you about Lovable. Lovable is an application that helps you to create website or software with AI. But a good feature that Lovable has is that you can import a design you did in Figma to Lovable and continue iterate on it on Lovable. So what we'll do today, we will take a landing page of a coffee shop, import the wireframe that I built in Figma to Lovable, and then we start to iterate on the visual design in Lovable, and you will see how you can iterate and discover the visual design for the website you create very easily in Lovable. So let's move to Figma. I'm here in Figma with a very simple homepage, as you can see here, that I built with wireframes for a coffee shop. The coffee shop concept is a coffee shop that brings coffee from all over the world. So this is the concept. And as you can see here, we have the header, the hero, our specialty section, a section about the theme, gallery with images from the coffee shop. Below we have a simple form to get in touch and the footer. I have a real list of different design style like neo-brutalist, minimalist, dark mode and more. And apart from that, color scheme, as you can see here. So we'll take some styles from these two lists and iterate in Lovable about the visual design. That's where we'll be able to discover different design styles in very easy way. So instead of create different design style and move the boxes in Figma, you just need to import the wireframe to Lovable and there with AI, iterate on the visual design. So the first thing is to import the wireframe to Lovable. How we do it? You need to open the Builder.io plugin and export the wireframe to Lovable. So let's do it together. I open the menu here, click on the Builder.io plugin, and now I need to select the frame I want to import to Lovable. So in that case, let's take this frame, click on export design, and now it's prepared the frame, so we're able to import this frame. It can take 1 or 2 minutes, but basically it's quite fast. It's finished, and as you can see, we have two options to select from. Let's put it in the center. So we have two options to select from, this one and that one. It gives you the ability to select the design that it's more close to your design, because the AI not always take 100% our design for Figma. But in that case, I think the first one is good and it looks like my design, so I click on it. And then we have two options. One is to view and call the builder, another one, open Lovable. In that case, I will click on Open in Lovable. You can click on View Code in Builder. It gives you more features to play with, but in our case, Open in Lovable will enough. It will give us the final result, and with the chat, we'll able to iterate with the visual design. So for this case, I open it in Lovable, and then it start to export it. Again, it can take 1 or 2 minutes to finish the task. In the meantime, I just want to tell you that when you export a frame to Lovable, make sure that the frame not has more than 3000 height pixels. Because if it has more than 3000 pixel height, it's difficult to Lovable to export it. So less than 3000 pixels make a better job. And another important thing to help Lovable understand your design, use auto layout, so it will be able to create your design more precise in the Lovable app. Now it's open Lovable and add all the information to Lovable. It's open it automatically, you don't need to do anything. It's finished the work, and as you can see here, we have the wireframe websites that we built. It didn't take all the visual design. As you can see here, we have a simple problem, but for me now it's okay, because basically I will add images, so no problem for that. And just let you know that if you want to see the wall page, you can click here and you will see it in 100%. I close it. If you want to see it in mobile size, you can click here and you will see the mobile size that Lovable create for you. I will back now to the desktop size, and the first thing that I want to do is change the color palette. So I will write here on the chat, change the entire homepage to one color scheme. I said it also that I don't want it to change the structure. I want it to change only the color. So I will click here on submit. In the chat, you can see now the step it does to change the color scheme, as you can see here. Okay, now we have one problem, but it's easy to fix. So the only thing that I need to click is try to fix, and the AI will handle it and fix it. It's finished the work, and as you can see here, it's created a page with warm color style. So as you can see, it's very easy to me to start to understand what color palette I want to the website. And it was one click, I don't need to do more. And now let's say that I want to test another color palette. I pasted the prompt and I used the same prompt as before. I just changed the color palette that now I want a cool color palette. You can see it here. And now I will submit and waiting that Lovable will handle the task so I can see the new color scheme. It's finished, and as you can see here, all the color palette changed to cool color palette. You can see it here. To take it one step further, I want to add a little bit image to this wireframe. So In our gallery, I have a section of images, but we need to add images. We could import it from the Figma files, but if you don't have images, there is no problem. I wrote to Lovable that I want images to the Our Gallery section, and you can see it here, add images to the Our Gallery section, and I explained to Lovable that I want it to find the images of free stock images website, and I ask it not to make any other changes. So let's submit it, and now it will find images and add them to the website. Okay, it gives us the images. As you can see here, it added images to the page. The next thing that I want to do is to change the visual style of all the page. I write it that I want it will change all the visual design to Neo Brutalist and keep the same color scheme. As you can see here, I write the prompt, change the entire homepage UI design into Neo Brutalist design style, keep using the same color scheme that fits coffee shop websites. Okay, and then I ask it also to don't change the page structure. So let's execute and see the result. Okay, it's finished the work, and as you can see here, all the visual design of the page changed to Neo Brutalist design. I scroll down a little bit here, you can see the boxes. It's added also boxes here, and also stock for the images and the form, as you can see it here. Now imagine that you want to test another design style, so it's very easy. Let's say that you want to change the design to minimalist design. So I write you the prompt, change the entire homepage design into minimalist design, keep the same color scheme and don't change the structure of the page. I will click submit and let's see what it will give for us. It's finished the work, and as you can see here, it's created for us the websites in minimalist design. You can see it here. Also, it's added an image here that I don't like, but in general, this is more or less the work. Before finish, I want to change also this image, but I will do it in another technique. You can go here below and click on edit and then select the image. Click on attach image and then select the photo that you want to add to the interface. So I click on open and you can see how it's added the image that I selected here. Click on save and that's all. So basically, as you saw, you can create changes from the chat or select a specific object and make changes on it. But at the end, it's a very great way to take a wireframe or basic design, upload to Loveable, ask for changes, iterate with the style and discover the style you want. And the last thing, if you want to see all your history, just click here on history and you will be able to see all the changes you did on the page. So let's select for here this one, and you can see the Neo Brutalist design. I can click this one and see the minimalist design with this forest image. And the last one that we did, we added this image of the coffee shop. So now you have a new technique to discover visual design for your next website. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to LogRocket for more design tips.